Well, obviously that wasn't much fun. They're an incredible team, and I don't know what it is about them that brings the worst out of us, and I think us that brings the best out of them. But, you know, that's kind of on me as much as the team. I thought there's not too much to say. Our kids kept playing hard. You know, it just was one of those games where absolutely nothing was going our way. They hit threes. They scored in the post. They scored mid-range jumpers. They scored on four different defenses that we played against them. So, you know, when you play a top 50 RPI team, you have to be at your best, and it just doesn't seem like we can quite get there. It seemed like we were a little indecisive offensively and maybe a little afraid to make mistakes at the beginning, and then the game kind of gets away from you and you're scrambling from there. So overall, you know, the thing I told the girls' locker room is to not let this game take away from what was a tremendous season. If you had told me, you know, 4 or 5 years ago that we'd have back-to-back 20-win seasons and, you know, beat a nationally ranked team on the road, and I think put ourselves in great position to make our third postseason in a row, I'd be really, really proud. And so I'm proud of this team that's gotten us there.
Let's take questions for Morgan. We'll start down here in the front.
I think it's just their athleticism and how long they are. It looks like when we drive, it looks like it could be open, but then they crash really hard and they really do a good job at bluffing and then getting out to our shooters. So I think, I mean, it gives a testament to them of how good of a defensive team they are and how fundamentally sound they are.
Sam Cooper from Regional Media. Morgan, you guys have made a lot of comebacks by very wide margins. Is there a certain point in this game that you really felt like it got away from you guys?
I wouldn't say there was a certain point. I just know that our team, we out of halftime, we wanted to play like it was 0-0, not worry about it. And then during the fourth quarter, I told the girls, just now don't even worry about the score right now. Just play our game. And, I mean, if we came back, it would have been great, but it was obviously a tough hole that we dug ourselves into.
Let's take one over here.
Based on how well you played against Omaha, were you expecting to come in and play well offensively in this game? Did you have some confidence coming in?
Yeah, I feel like every time I come out, I have confidence. I didn't really play my best at Omaha. I think MMT did a great job playing against Omaha, but I knew that for us to beat South Dakota State, that I had to step up. We needed to have a well-rounded group effort.
I was referring more to the team as a whole, just kind of coming in.
For sure. No, we knew that we needed to play well to pull off a win. But I just think that it kind of got a little out of control there.
Any other questions for Morgan? Okay, if not, we'll go ahead and excuse you back to the locker room. Thank you. And we'll take some questions for Coach.
No questions, thanks.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're enough easy on this one. We'll take a couple down here.
Man, I wish I knew. I mean, I almost felt the whole game almost apologetic to our players, even our fans, because it's like I couldn't figure it out. You know, we couldn't figure out now in three games why we just can't seem to get anything going offensively. And you know, it's funny because we made three different adjustments every time we played them. You know, last year I thought we competed really well against them and we were able to score the basketball. And so, you know, maybe credit to them. Maybe they figured something out and I haven't quite kind of figured out the other way. But, I mean, it just seemed like everything they did well. I mean, I literally at halftime we were talking coaching staff and I could not think of one thing that, you know, we won on. You know, I mean, our effort was at least close, but I mean, they had really good effort too. So their effort probably even won. Their rebounding for sure won. Their shooting, obviously. They're attacking the basket with body control. Their defense, you know, they turned us over more than we turned them over, which almost never happens to us. So, you know, it was just kind of a lack of answers. And, you know, I wish I knew here's what we need to do and how to fix it. But that's not always the case in coaching, unfortunately.
There's a question all the way in the back.
Yeah, I know last year you guys came in here and won the tournament title, but this year, obviously a little different story. Does it become difficult when you guys are, you know, within six, within eight, within 10 early, and then the crowd gets into it and really takes over and pumps up SDSU. Does that become a challenge for your team? And, you know, it's supposed to be a quote-unquote neutral site, or is that something that doesn't factor in at all for you guys?
I mean, I think it's, you know, it's like any other playing in a away game. But, you know, it wasn't an impact today for sure. I mean, we could have played in front of, you know, we had a huge social media following with Leatherneck fans. And I think we could have had 6,000 fans here to battle South Dakota State's fans. And, you know, I mean, we got outplayed. I mean, there's nothing else really to say, and I will never ever, and I said this last year, I will never ever hold it against South Dakota State for having a great following. I mean, for women's basketball to play in front of 5,000-6,000, it can be really special. So I think if anything else, it adds to the disappointment for us, because we would have loved to have been in a battle. You know, we talked about kind of treating it like Rocky IV, where he goes into Russia and in the crowd, and by the end the crowd's rooting for Rocky, and I said the crowd probably won't flip and root for us, but and I think they were really looking forward to kind of that challenge and just battling against that crowd, and so I think that added maybe to the disappointment a little bit.